Amen, amen. Today we're going to continue our series on Thrive.
En este día vamos a continuar nuestra predicación.
And today I'm going to be talking about I want the true riches.
En este día voy a hablar quiero las verdaderas riquezas.
Everyone say true riches. In the first week we learned about bread and seed.
En la primera semana aprendimos del pan y la semilla.
And our seed is for what?
Y la semilla es para qué?
Planting.
Es para plantar.
And our bread is to what?
Eat, enjoy.
To eat and enjoy. That's what you buy your things with.
Y el pan para qué es? Es para comer.
And then we learned about sowing and reaping.
Y también aprendimos sobre sembrando y recogiendo.
You reap what you sow.
Usted recoge lo que siembra.
And then last week we talked about can I trust you?
Y la semana pasada hablamos, ¿puedo confiar en ti?
And this week we're going to continue building our financial house.
Y en esta semana vamos a seguir construyendo finanzas en nuestra casa.
If you missed any of those sermons, you can go back to that same Facebook page. And our sermons are right there for you to see them or watch them again. Isaiah chapter 28 verse 10.
En Isaías 28:10 dice de esta manera.
For precept must be upon precept, a line upon line, here a little and there a little. I want you to touch your neighbor and say, I want to learn.
I want to learn.
Today we're going to talk about another parable.
En este día vamos a hablar sobre otra parábola.
That Jesus talked about money.
Que Jesucristo habló sobre el dinero.
But it also has deep spiritual revelations in it for us.
También tiene una profunda revelación espiritual.
If you're ready, say amen.
Amen.
All right, we got most of you ready. Amen. We're going to open up to Luke chapter 16.
Vamos a ver Lucas capítulo 16.
Verses 1 and 2.
Del 1 al 2.
This is what it says.
Y esto es lo que dice siguiente.
Jesus told his disciples, there was a rich man. Everyone say rich.
Rich.
A rich man whose manager was accused of wasting his possessions. So he called him in and asked him, what is this I hear about you? Give an account for your management because you cannot be manager any longer. So Jesus tells us there was a rich man.
Jesucristo en esta parábola nos dice que había un hombre rico.
And this rich man hears that one of his managers or stewards was wasting his money.
Y uno de los managers aquí está malgastando y usando su dinero.
So whether it is a manager or a steward, they made some bad choices or some bad investments.
So esta persona lo que hizo, escogió unos inversiones que hizo equivocadamente.
And so the boss calls him in.
So su amo le llamó.
And he says, give account to what you were doing.
Y le dijo, dime de lo que estás haciendo.
Now this man, he wasn't stealing.
Este hombre, este manager, no estaba robando.
He wasn't robbing from him.
Él no estaba robando al amo.
He was just making some bad investment choices with his possessions and money.
So lo que él estaba haciendo, estaba invirtiendo mal.
The rich man,
el hombre rico,
represents God.
Representa a Dios.
And we represent the manager or the steward.
Y nosotros representamos al manager.
And there's a day coming.
Y hay un día que va a venir.
Where God is going to call us in.
Que Dios nos va a llamar a rendirle cuentas.
If we haven't managed his bread and seed properly.
Y si haberse hemos manejado correctamente las semillas que nos ha dado.
How are you managing the bread and the seed?
¿Cómo tú estás manejando el pan y la semilla que Él te ha dado?
See, we're going to another level now.
Sí, vamos a ir a otro nivel.
We went beyond the stealing.
Ya fuimos, ya sobrepasamos el robo.
That's level one.
Eso es el nivel número uno.
Maybe you're not stealing.
Quizás tú no estás robando.
But are you managing what God has given you well?
Pero tú estás manejando lo que Dios ha puesto en tus manos.
Because the religious spirit can come in.
Porque el espíritu religión puede venir.
And say, oh, I'm not stealing.
Y puede decir, oh, yo no estoy robando.
But I'm not managing very well.
Pero uno no está manejando correctamente el dinero que se ha puesto, lo que se ha puesto a nosotros.
And the boss one day is going to call you in.
Y el amo, un día que el amo representa a Dios, te va a llamar para pedir cuentas.
And we're not just talking about finances that you're managing.
Y no nomás estamos hablando de finanzas que tú estás como manager.
We're also talking about your gifts.
También estamos hablando de tus dones.
Are you managing your gifts well?
¿Estás manejando tus dones correctamente?
Do you even know what gift you have?
¿Sabes cuáles son tus dones?
And if you don't know your gift,
si tú no conoces tus dones,
why don't you know it?
¿Por qué no lo sabes?
Don't say, well, oh, the church hasn't told me yet.
Oh, no, vamos a decir, la iglesia no me ha dicho.
It's not the responsibility of the church.
No es la responsabilidad de la iglesia.
Does the church tell you what size of pants to wear?
La iglesia te dice qué medida de pantalones debes de usar.
What do? You find out for yourself.
¿Qué es lo que haces? Tú los compras.
If you're a size, you know, 38.
Si tú eres tu size 38,
and you buy a pant that is size 28,
y si tú compras una que es 28,
guess what?
¿Qué tú crees que va a pasar?
It ain't gonna fit.
No te va a quedar.
You're gonna try as much as you can.
Vas a tratar lo más que puedas.
But it won't fit.
Pero no te va a quedar.
You're gonna find out that maybe 20 years ago I was a 28, amen.
Tú vas a encontrar o a saber que quizás hace 20 años atrás te podía haber quedado.
But 20 years and thousands of enchiladas later.
Pero 20 años comiendo enchiladas después.
Now I'm a 38.
Now es un 38.
I can't fit in that.
Ya no puede quedar en los 28.
Nobody has to tell me that.
Nadie me tiene que decir esto.
I can find out for myself.
Yo puedo saber por mí mismo.
So you're gifting.
So tú tienes dones.
What are you doing and how are you managing your gifts?
Él te va a preguntar qué es lo que, cómo tú estás haciendo con los dones que te ha dado.
Maybe some of you know have a gift of teaching.
Quizás alguno de ustedes tiene el don de enseñar.
Are you teaching?
¿Estás enseñando?
Well, they don't give me an opportunity, pastor.
Well, dice, no me dan una oportunidad.
There is a harvest field out there waiting for anyone to teach them the word of God.
Hay una cosecha allá afuera que tú puedes decirle la palabra del Señor.
There are so many classrooms out there that you can teach in.
Hay muchas partes donde tú puedes estar enseñando allá afuera.
Don't limit your vision to just what's inside the four walls of the church.
No te limites en las cuatro paredes de esta iglesia.
Are you a good manager?
¿Eres un buen manejador, un buen manager?
Maybe some of you can sing.
Quizás alguno de ustedes pueden cantar.
I tried, but they won't let me.
El pastor trata, pero es mejor que no cante, hermanos.
I told Di I can do this. But she don't give me the microphone. I'm like, this is my church. Sing if I want to sing. Amen.
Él dice que él puede cantar.
But maybe some of you can sing.
Quizás alguno de ustedes sabe cantar.
Maybe some of you can play an instrument.
Quizás de alguno de ustedes puede tocar un instrumento.
How are you managing that gift?
¿Qué es lo que tú estás haciendo con ese don que Dios te ha dado?
Well, you say, well, maybe I'm not that good yet, pastor. Well, then go out there and teach yourself. Get some classes. Learn. Train, get better, so that you can use your gift wisely.
Dice que vaya uno allá afuera a tratar, que vaya uno a practicar para que puedas hacer, usar el don que Dios te ha dado bien.
So it's not just about stealing.
No nomás es acerca de robar.
That's level one.
Ese es el nivel uno.
We're going line upon line and precept upon precept.
Vamos a ir de nivel a nivel a nivel.
So now we're going deeper to another level.
Ahora vamos profundamente a otro nivel.
Or maybe some of you are not managing your dreams very well.
Quizás de alguno de ustedes no están manejando sus sueños correctamente.
Maybe some of you say, you know what? I never dream.
Quizás uno de ustedes diga, yo nunca sueño.
You know why you never dream?
¿Sabe por qué nunca sueñan?
Because you declare you never dream.
Porque tú declaras, nunca sueñas.
So you tell God, don't give me no dreams.
So tú le dices, Dios, no me des sueños.
And then out of that same mouth you cry out to God and say, I don't dream.
Entonces nosotros decimos, Señor, yo no sueño.
I want to dream.
Yo quiero soñar.
But God says you made a declaration that says, I don't dream.
Pero dice Dios que tú has hecho una declaración, yo no sueño.
See, God speaks to us through dreams.
Sí, el Señor nos habla a través de los sueños.
He wants to speak to you.
Quiere hablarte a ti.
Don't be afraid.
No tengas miedo.
How are you managing that?
¿Cómo tú estás manejando esto?
Or maybe your prophetic gifting.
O quizás tú tienes un don profético.
The Bible says, and Paul says, that he desires for all of us to prophesy.
La Biblia dice, y Pablo dice en la Biblia, que su deseo es que todos profeticemos.
Now we can all prophesy at different levels.
Now, vamos a profetizar quizás en niveles diferentes.
Someone might prophesy at this level.
Quizás muchos profeticen en un nivel alto.
And maybe some of you prophesy at this level.
Quizás uno de ustedes profetice en un nivel bajo.
But that's okay.
Pero eso está bien.
The question is,
la pregunta es,
are you prophesying?
¿Tú estás profetizando?
And if you're not,
y si no lo estás haciendo,
why not?
¿Por qué no?
It's quiet in this Presbyterian church.
Están muy callados en una iglesia presbiteriana.
Are you managing your gifts well?
¿Estás manejando tus dones correctamente?
I gotta move on. We could be on there for a while. But let's go on. Luke chapter 16, verses 3 to 4.
Ahora vamos a ver Lucas, capítulo 16, versículo del 3 al 4.
The manager said to himself, "What shall I do now? My master is taking away my job." Check this out. He's at least smart enough to realize his limitations. He says, "I'm not strong enough to dig." He says, "I'm not one of those mule workers out there. I can't do that." And then he says, "And I'm too ashamed to beg." You know, he must not never heard that song, "Ain't Too Ashamed to Beg." Some of you know that song. Amen. Verse 4. "I know what I'll do so that when I lose my job here, people will welcome me into their houses." The manager realizes he can't do manual labor.
El manager realizó que no sabía o no podía hacer labor manual.
He has too much pride to go out and beg.
Él tenía mucho, era muy orgulloso para ir a pedir.
So he comes up with a plan.
So él vino con un plan.
That he thinks that's going to take care of himself.
Que él pensó que esto iba a cuidar de él.
How did the manager get to this position?
¿Cómo es que el manager llegó a esta posición?
The manager probably thought his boss wouldn't care about his bad investments.
Quizás el manager pensó que su amo no le iba a importar los malos invertimientos que hizo.
Because, man, my boss, he's so rich, he won't miss it.
Porque él pensó, oh, el amo es muy rico que no va a ver la diferencia.
Or maybe he thought to himself, I'm too valuable for this company.
O quizás él pensó, Yo soy muy valorable para esta compañía.
He'll never let me go. He needs me.
Nunca me va a dejar ir o me va a despedir porque él me necesita.
You know, he says, you know, I'm all that and a bag of chips. Amen. Some of us think like that, right?
Quizás muchos pensamos así.
We think God needs us.
Pensamos que Dios nos necesita a nosotros.
Or the church, man, needs us. If we're not there, it's going to fall apart.
O la iglesia nos necesita. Si no estoy ahí, se va a caer.
He thought he couldn't be replaced.
Él pensó que no iba a ser reemplazado.
Or maybe he said, well, you know what? I'm such a good talker. I can talk my way out of this situation.
O él pensó, yo sé hablar muy bien, que yo puedo salir de esta situación.
But none of that worked.
Pero nada de eso trabajó.
See, don't think.
No pienses.
That God doesn't see how we steward what he's been given to us.
Que él no pienses.
That God doesn't see how we steward what's been given to us.
Oh, no pienses que Dios no ve lo que Dios nos da a nosotros.
He's the one who gave you the talent.
Es el que te da el talento.
He's the one who gave you the gift.
Es el que te da el don.
He's the one that's giving you your finances.
Es el que te da tus finanzas.
He is watching everything.
Él está mirando todo.
Don't ever think that you're God's gift to the church.
Hallelujah.
Is there some people who think that I'm God's gift to the church?
Ellos piensan que somos como dones para la iglesia.
The church is so lucky to have me.
So la iglesia piensa, oh, tienen tanta suerte de tenerme a mí aquí.
Let me tell you something.
Déjame decirte algo.
God can.
Dios puede.
And God will.
Y Dios lo hará.
Replace us.
Él nos puede reemplazar.
If we're not living up to his standards.
Si no estamos viviendo como Dios quiere que vivamos.
And if we're wasting his resources. God will replace me.
Dios nos puede reemplazar.
There's nobody in this church that's irreplaceable.
No hay ninguna persona aquí que no pueda ser reemplazable.
One day God is going to call us out and say, "Give an account for what you've been given."
Un día Dios nos va a preguntar qué hemos hecho con lo que Él nos ha dado.
And then he will allow others to rise up.
Y va a permitir a otros levantarse.
And take the positions that were supposed to be yours.
Y tomar la posición que estaba supuesta ser tuya.
I wish we had some more time. Luke chapter 16 verses 5 to 7.
Lucas capítulo 16 del 5 al 7.
So he called in each one of his master's debtors. This is now the manager coming up with his plan. And he asked the first, "How much do you owe my master?" 900 gallons of olive oil, he replied. The manager said, "All right, take your bill, sit down quickly, and make it only 450. Then he asked the second person, "How much do you owe?" 1,000 bushels of wheat, he replied. He told them, "Take your bill now and make it 800. Now, the manager's plan,
el plan del manager era este.
Was to bring people who owed his boss money.
Era traer gente que le debía a su amo.
Or things.
O cosas.
And cut their bill.
Y cortar lo que debía.
So that once he was thrown out of the house.
Una vez que ellos ya fueran sacados afuera de la casa.
That these people he helped.
A estas personas que él ayudó.
Would remember him in his time of need.
Que lo recuerden al manager en el tiempo de necesidad.
He's like, if I take care of them,
él dijo, si yo cuido de ellos,
they'll take care of me.
Ellos me van a cuidar a mí.
The boss finds out about his manager's plan.
El amo descubrió el plan del manager.
And this is what he says.
Y esto es lo que dijo.
Luke chapter 16, verses 8 to 9.
Lucas capítulo 16, versículo del 8 al 9.
And it will surprise you what he says. The master commended. Check it out. Everyone say commended. The master commended the dishonest manager because he acted shrewdly. You think he would tell him off. But right now, he says, he commends him for the people. Check what he says now. For the people of this world are more shrewd in dealing with their own kind than the people of the what?
Life. Come on, man.
Look what's happening here. He says, now he says, let me give you a word of advice. I tell you, use worldly wealth to gain friends for yourselves so that when it's gone, you will be welcome into eternal dwellings. This answer is not what you would expect.
Esa no era la contestación que tú esperabas.
The manager commended his dishonest worker.
El manager le dijo al trabajador deshonesto.
So the question is, why?
La pregunta es qué.
Why would he commend this dishonest man?
La pregunta es por qué mandó a este hombre deshonesto.
Because now he's robbing from him.
Porque ahora está robando.
Before he was just wasting.
Anteriormente nomás estaba tirando el dinero lo que tenía del amo.
But now he's robbing from him.
Pero ahora está robando de él.
And instead of the boss getting upset.
En vez del amo se fuera hecho, estaba enojado.
He commands him.
Él le dice, le ordena.
Now, this part.
Mire esta parte.
Grab the attention of Jesus' disciples.
Esta parte tomó la atención de los apóstoles de Jesús.
And also the Pharisees.
Y también de los fariseos.
Because they were listening to this story.
Porque los fariseos estaban escuchando esta historia.
Jesus had an awesome plan that he was doing right here.
Jesús tenía un plan que estaba haciendo en ese momento.
Because all of them are thinking the same way we're thinking. Now the word commended.
Now la palabra mandar.
In the Greek.
En el griego.
It means to praise appropriate to the situation.
Quiere decir adorar apropiadamente en la situación.
So according to the situation, will the praise come?
De acuerdo de la situación es cuando la adoración viene.
So he said, well, at least, this is what the boss says now. Well, at least you went out and did something.
Dice, de verdad tú fuiste afuera, hiciste algo.
Even though it was wrong,
aunque lo hiciste equivocadamente,
you didn't just sit back and cry about the situation.
No nomás te relajaste y lloraste sobre la situación.
And hope something would happen.
Y esperando que algo pasara.
The boss gave his dishonest manager now some advice.
El amo le dio un aviso o le dijo cómo hiciera las cosas.
He said to use money.
Que usara el dinero.
While you have access to it.
Cuando todavía tenía acceso a él.
So that when it's gone.
Para cuando se terminara.
You at least gained enough friends.
Tuviera suficiente amigos.
To take care of you until you can find something else.
Para que cuidara de ti mientras encontrabas algo nuevo.
Check this out. God is telling us.
So, miren esto. Dios nos está diciendo esto.
We need to help others.
Necesitamos ayudar a otros.
So that when something happens to us.
Para si nos pasa algo a nosotros.
Like as Christians.
Como cristianos.
We can have a place where we can go where people can help us.
Podríamos tener un lugar donde la gente nos puede ayudar.
We need a place.
Necesitamos un lugar.
The church is supposed to be that place.
La iglesia está supuesto a ser ese lugar.
Where people can come.
Donde la gente puede venir.
And receive help.
Y recibir ayuda.
During their times of need.
En los tiempos de necesidad.
But what Jesus was saying here.
Pero lo que está diciendo Jesucristo aquí.
He's saying the people in the world help their people more than the people inside the church.
So la gente del mundo ayuda más a su gente que la gente de la iglesia.
Amen. Because what do we do as church people?
¿Qué es lo que hacemos como iglesia?
One of the things we say is, we'll pray for you. Right? That's the Christian answer to say. Someone comes with a need, hey, we'll pray for you.
Lo que hicimos la gente de iglesia, cuando una persona viene con necesidad, vamos a orar por ti. Está duro.
But also the person,
pero también la persona,
who is about to get fired,
que va a ser corrida,
he had a part to play too.
También tenía una parte que jugar en esto.
He didn't just sit home and cry, oh, my boss is about to fire me.
Pero no nomás lloró y dijo, oh, mi boss está a punto de correrme.
I got nowhere to go.
No tengo un lugar que ir.
He went out and he came up with a plan.
Él fue allá afuera y pensó.
See,
a lot
of times we as Christians,
muchas veces nosotros como cristianos,
when something happens to us,
cuando algo nos pasa a nosotros,
we just sit and we just cry and cry and cry.
Nomás nos sentamos y nos lamentamos.
And we ask God, why did this happen?
Y decimos, oh Dios, ¿por qué me ha pasado a mí esto?
God says, get up.
Y Dios dice, levántate.
Do something.
Haz algo.
Go out there and find something.
Ve afuera y encuentra algo.
Get out there and work.
Ve afuera y comienza a trabajar.
Because look what James chapter 2 verse 26 says.
Fíjese lo que nos dice Santiago.
For as the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without works is what?
Dead also.
Dead. You can have all the faith you want.
Tú puedes tener toda la fe que tengas.
But if you ain't working your faith.
Pero si tú no estás trabajando sobre tu fe.
The Bible says your faith is dead.
Dice, tu fe es muerta.
Don't just pray about the situation.
No nomás ores por la situación.
You have a need.
Tú tienes una
necesidad.
Don't
just pray.
No nomás ores.
I'm not saying not to pray.
Yo no estoy diciendo que no ores.
I'm just telling you, just don't just pray.
Ya, lo que estoy diciendo, no nomás ores.
Go out there and do something about it.
Ve afuera y comienza a hacer algo.
Get out there and work.
Ve allá afuera y comienza
a
trabajar.
Get out there and do something.
Ve allá afuera y haz algo.
You have an issue with the church.
¿Tienes algún problema con la iglesia?
You say, why? We want the church to grow.
¿Cómo es que queremos que la iglesia crezca?
Don't just pray about it.
No nomás ores.
Go out there and bring the people in.
Ve afuera y trae la gente.
If that means driving your car to pick up people.
Eso quiere decir que si tienes que manejar tu carro.
Then drive the car and pick up people and bring them.
Pues ve y maneja tu carro y tráelos
a la iglesia. So that the house of God may be full.
Para que la casa del Señor esté llena.
Don't just pray and cry.
No nomás ores y llores.
Go out there and work.
Ve allá afuera y comienza a trabajar.
Because the harvest is ready.
Porque está lista para levantar la cosecha.
Jesus said, but the laborers are few.
Pero Jesucristo dice, pero los trabajadores son pocos.
There's a lot of talkers.
Hay muchos que hablan.
But few workers.
Pero hay muy pocos trabajadores.
It's quiet in this Baptist church. Amen. Somebody say amen. We got to get out there and work, church.
Tenemos que ir para afuera, iglesia, y comenzar a trabajar.
Then all of a sudden,
y de repente,
Jesus says,
Jesucristo dijo,
when the money is gone,
cuando el dinero se te acabe,
you will have eternal dwellings.
Vas a tener eterna vida.
Now this really grabs the attention of everyone listening.
Esto grabó la atención de todos aquellos que estaban escuchando.
See, Jesus is a master storyteller. He's a master storyteller. He knows how to grab the attention of people.
Sí, Jesucristo es un maestro historiador.
He has the disciples listening.
Él tenía a sus discípulos escuchando.
And he has the Pharisees listening.
Y también tenía a los fariseos escuchando.
And all the other people that were there just listening.
Y también la otra gente que estaban ahí estaban escuchando.
Now all of them are listening because he just said, when the money runs out, you're going to have eternal dwellings. What does that mean?
Y todos comenzaron a escuchar juntos porque dijeron que cuando tuvieras eterna vida.
And now that Jesus has their attention.
Ahora Jesucristo, cuando dijo esas palabras, ahora Jesucristo, todos comenzaron a estar atentos a sus palabras.
Now he brings in a powerful spiritual truth here.
Él trajo un algo especial, algo poderoso, una verdadera espiritualidad.
Verses 10 to 12 in Luke, same chapter.
Capítulo Lucas 16, del 10 al 12.
Whoever, everyone say whoever, can be trusted with very little, can also be trusted with what?
With much.
And whoever is dishonest with very little will also be dishonest with what?
Much.
So if you have not been trustworthy in handling worldly wealth, see, this is how Jesus puts it all together now. Who will trust you with what? With the true riches. And if you have not been trustworthy with someone else's property, who will give you property of what?
Of your own.
God is evaluating your stewardship over what he has given to you.
Dios está evaluando lo que te ha dado.
And he's not just talking about finances.
Y no nomás está hablando sobre finanzas.
He's talking about your gifting.
Está hablando sobre tus talentos.
He's talking about your talents.
Está hablando sobre los de los que te dan los gifts.
And he's talking about the revelations that you receive from God.
También está hablando de las revelaciones que tú recibes de Dios.
And so much more.
Y muchas cosas
we
más.
We just don't have time to get into those. Then in verse 12,
en el verso 12,
he hits now hard on money.
Ahora habla duramente en el dinero.
Everyone say money.
Money.
Cuz he says this. If you can't handle worldly money,
si no puedes manejar el dinero del mundo,
why would I give you true riches?
Porque yo te voy a dar riquezas verdaderas.
In other words, if you eat your seeds instead of planting it, why would I give you true riches?
En otra cosa, si en vez de sembrar te estás comiendo las semillas que te está dando, ¿por qué te va a dar riquezas verdaderas?
So the key words here,
so la llave aquí es,
is true riches.
Es riquezas verdaderas.
What does that mean?
¿Qué es lo que quieres decir esto?
Ask me. I'm glad you asked. The phrase true riches in the Greek.
La frase verdaderas riquezas en griego significa esto.
Has nothing to do with money.
No tiene que ver nada con dinero.
True riches is not money. God is not saying true riches has anything to do with money.
Dios no está diciendo que riquezas verdaderas significa todo, está hablando sobre dinero.
True riches means this.
Riquezas verdaderas significa esto.
The full revelation of God's faithfulness.
Una completa revelación de la fe de Dios.
So check this out.
Fíjense en esto.
God is saying if you can't handle money.
So Dios dice si tú no puedes mantener o usar el dinero.
You can't handle my revelation.
Tú no puedes aguantar mis revelaciones o trabajar con mis revelaciones.
So some of you might be wondering, why do I get any deep revelations from God?
So alguien está pensando, ¿por qué yo voy a tener revelaciones profundas de Dios?
Because you don't know how to handle money.
Porque tú no sabes cómo usar el dinero.
And if you can't handle money,
si no puedes saber usar el dinero,
why would God give you true riches?
Porque Dios te va a dar riquezas verdaderas.
Why would he waste his investment of revelation on you?
Porque él va a perder las revelaciones que te está dando en ti.
If you're wasting the finances that he gives you.
Si tú estás desperdiciando las finanzas que Dios te está dando.
We're not talking about stealing now.
No estamos hablando ahora sobre robar.
You can be giving your tithes and offering correctly.
Tú puedes dar tus ofrendas y tus diezmos correctamente.
But the way you're using your finances is not pleasing to God.
Pero como tú estás usando tus finanzas, quizás no están agradando a Dios.
It's quiet here. So you're going to a deeper revelation now.
Sí, vamos a una revelación un poco más profunda.
We're beyond the God is love now. We're beyond the stealing of the money.
Ya pasamos sobre robar el dinero.
Line upon line, precept upon precept.
Vamos a ir de un nivel a otro nivel.
If you want to stay down here on ground one, you can stay down there.
Si tú quieres estar aquí mero abajo.
But the revelations are very shallow here.
Pero las revelaciones son muy pocas aquí, muy bajas.
Those are God is love. There's a heaven and there's a hell. Jesus loves you. If you want to stay in that revelation,
si tú quieres estar en esa revelación como hay infierno, Dios te ama,
then keep wasting your money.
So sigue desperdiciando tu dinero.
See, you're not stealing from God, you're giving.
Si tú no estás robando, estás dando.
What God is asking of you,
de lo que te está preguntando Dios de ti.
Just like this steward was, he wasn't stealing.
Así como este manager no estaba robando.
But he wasn't managing the money well.
Pero no estaba manejando el dinero correctamente.
He wasn't managing his possessions well.
No estaba manejando sus posiciones correctamente.
Example, who gave you the car?
Por ejemplo, ¿quién te dio el carro?
God. Who gave you the ability to work? God.
God, Dios.
Who gave you the knowledge to be able to do that job? God.
¿Quién te dio la habilidad para hacer esto?
So
Dios.
So, reality, who does the car belong to?
So, ¿de quién pertenece el carro, entonces?
Everyone say? God. See, some of you don't want to say it. You're like, no, I ain't gonna say it.
So, ¿a quién pertenece el carro?
That car is mine.
Si Dios te ha dado la inteligencia.
I worked for it. I paid for it. That's why you don't want to say it.
Si usted...
Whose car is it? God's. So if it's God's car,
so si el carro pertenece a Dios,
then who do you use it for?
¿Para qué tú lo estás usando?
The things of the Lord.
¿Tú te has puesto a usarlo en las cosas del Señor?
Now if somebody needs help.
Now si alguien necesita ayuda.
They need a ride to church.
Se necesitan que los traigas a la iglesia.
What's your car for?
Entonces, ¿para qué es tu carro?
Come on now.
Díganme ahora.
Uber. You're like, that's the devil, Uber. It's fine. Give him the money to get Uber. Amen. Thank you, Brother Carlos. So if you need Uber, Brother Carlos said he'll take care of you. Amen. He said, let me take that back now. See, God is telling you.
So Dios está diciendo.
How you handle your money.
Como tú cuides tu dinero.
Will determine what level of revelation he can trust you with.
Y él dice en qué clase o qué nivel te va a dar la revelación.
Now let's read verse 13.
Ahora vamos a leer capítulo Lucas 16:13.
Our time is running out. It says, no one can serve two masters. Either you hate the one and love the other, or you'll be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and what? Now, the word serve in the Greek means this.
La palabra servir en griego significa esto.
To release all your personal ownership.
Dejar todo lo que te pertenece.
To release all your rights to another person.
Dale todos sus derechos a otra persona.
Willingly.
Lo va a hacer voluntariamente.
You give over the prerogative to be self-governing.
Lo da con la prerrogativa que se gobierne a sí mismo.
Now the question today,
la pregunta de hoy es,
who is your master?
¿Quién es tu amo?
Or you're from the, if you're from the city or from the hood, who's your daddy? Not showing up. That was back in the 80s, man. That was a karate movie, showing up. That's the question you need to ask. Who's your master? Who's your daddy?
La pregunta que necesitas hacer, ¿quién es tu amo?
Is it God?
¿Es Dios?
Or is it money?
¿O es el dinero?
Now the Greek word for money.
La palabra griega por dinero.
Means this.
Significa esto.
Doesn't necessarily mean just money.
No necesariamente nomás significa dinero.
It means this.
Significa esto.
The treasure.
El tesoro.
You put your heart in. And your trust. So who you put your trust in is your daddy.
¿En quién estás poniendo tu confianza?
That's your God.
Ese es tu Dios.
Whoever you put your trust in.
En cualquier que tú confíes.
Do you put your trust in your job?
Tú pones tu confianza en tu trabajo.
You put your trust in your finances.
Tú pones tu confianza en la finanza.
You put your trust in your possessions.
Tú confías en tus posiciones.
That is here today and gone tomorrow.
Que está aquí ahora y mañana ya no está.
Or do you put your trust in a God?
O tú confías en Dios.
Who is the same yesterday, today and forever?
Que es el mismo ayer, hoy, ahora y para siempre.
See, putting your trust in money.
Si confiar en el dinero.
Will never connect you with God.
Nunca te va a conectar con Dios.
But putting your trust in God.
Pero poniendo tu confianza en Dios.
Will connect you with money.
Te va a conectar con el dinero.
I wish somebody believed that here.
Oh, quisiera que alguien creyera eso.
Maybe the people in the balcony.
Quizás la gente en el balcony.
Our angels up there, maybe they believe that.
O quizás los ángeles crean eso.
Putting your trust in money.
Poniendo tu confianza en el dinero.
Will never connect you with God.
Nunca te va a conectar con Dios.
But putting your trust in God.
Pero poniendo tu confianza en Dios.
Will connect you with money.
Te va a conectar con el dinero.
Somebody praise the Lord.
Alguien adore a Dios en la casa.
If you put your trust in true riches.
Si pones tu confianza en verdaderas riquezas.
Which is the revelations of God.
¿Cuáles son las revelaciones de Dios?
That will connect you with money.
Esto te va a conectar con el dinero.
That you need to accomplish the goals that God has given to you.
Que necesitas completar lo que tú has pensado hacer.
I'm going to ask the worship team, come on up. We're landing this thing. Verses 14 to 15. The Pharisees who loved money heard all of this and were sneering at Jesus. He said to them, "You are the ones who justify yourselves in the eyes of others, but God knows your hearts. What people value highly is detestable in God's sight."
Amen.
Now, what does the word detestable mean?
¿Cuál es la palabra esto? Goler mal.
Detestable means this in the Greek.
Esta palabra significa esto en griego.
It means to emit a foul odor.
Quiere decir que emites un olor insoportable.
Or a stench.
O que huele más, apesta.
Now, here's the question.
Esta es la pregunta.
What kind of odor are you giving to God?
¿Qué clase de olor tú le estás dando a Dios?
How do you smell?
¿Cómo tú hueles?
Not physically.
No físicamente.
Don't look at your neighbor and sniff him.
No comiencen a golar a nadie.
Or the old commercial, "Are you sure?" We ain't talking about physical odor.
No estamos hablando de un olor físico.
But how do you smell to God?
¿Cómo tú hueles a Dios?
When you came into this place,
¿tú viniste a este lugar?
Did you bring in a beautiful odor into the house of God?
¿Trajiste un olor bueno a la casa del Señor?
Or did you bring a stench?
¿O tú trajiste un olor que no huele muy agradable?
That God says, "I can't even handle this smell anymore."
Que Dios dice, "Oh, yo no puedo estar en esto."
Because if you've ever been around somebody smelly in the physical.
Si tú alguna vez has estado alrededor de alguien que huele físicamente.
You don't want to be around someone like that.
No te gustaría estar alrededor de una persona así.
We've been on some mission trips.
Hemos estado en misiones.
We've been next to some people.
Hemos estado enseguida de personas.
They didn't smell like the presence of God.
Que no huelen como la presencia de Dios.
And it was hard to worship God.
Era un poco difícil adorar a Dios.
And that's physical smell.
Y es un olor físico.
That can go away with just water.
Que se puede ir nomás con agua.
And some soap.
Y con jabón.
But a spiritual stench.
Pero algo espiritual que huela mal.
You need to repent before God.
Necesitas arrepentirte en frente de Dios.
To get rid of that smell.
Para poder quitar ese olor.
Ephesians 5:2, and I close with this.
Efesios 5:2, y cerramos con esto.
And walk in love, as Christ also loved us, and given himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God, for what? A sweet smelling aroma. Don't tell me that God is not worried about how you smell.
No me digas que Dios no se preocupa como tú hueles.
I pray that you smell awesome before God.
Yo oro porque tú huelas grandemente bien en frente de Dios.
Close your eyes with me this afternoon.